Hello everyone, hope you are always safe and healthy wherever you are. Today, I will be talking about Google Sheets blog at Automa. At this time, we have more advanced tutorials, but I promise this will be more helpful too for the repetitive tasks that you're working for. In the first example, I will show you how to send emails using the data from Google Sheets, and maybe it will save your marketing fees. Okay, let's say you already have the data on Google Sheets like this. You have name and email columns like this. Okay, now you need to share it to service@automa2.im.dservice.com. As a viewer, share and then click on the share anyway. Back again to the Automa dashboard and create a new workflow here with a name, maybe send emails. Open this workflow and add Google Sheets block here. We need to get the spreadsheet ID. It's in the URL here. Select this and copy, paste it to here. For a range value, we can select from A column to B, like this. And then for the reference key, we can give it a name, maybe data, and check use the first row as keys. We can click on the preview data here, and we will have array of object name and email here. Okay, connect it with the trigger block. And then we need to add a loop data block here. For the ID, we can update to emails and loop through Google Sheets. For the reference key, we can use data here, connect it with the previous block, and then we can add a new tab block here for open Google email. Okay, select the URL and copy, paste it to the new tab URL here. And then we need to fill in 3 forms here, to subject and message body, and then click on the send button here. Back again to the editor and add 3 forms like this. Okay, for sure add click element 2, connect it all like this. And for the first form, we need to get the element selector here. So we need to use the element selector here. Click on the two form here, and we will have the element with an attribute area label here. Okay, we can use the area label. We can type area label 2. And check wait for selector. For the value, we can use loop data at emails.email. And the typing delay, we can use maybe 30 milliseconds like this. Okay, and then for the forms, the next forms, we need to click on the subject form here. And then we can use the area label again, area label subject. We need to type area dash label subject like this. And then for the value, maybe we can type hi loop data at emails.name like this with the typing delay 32. And then for the last forms, we need to select message body here. We can use the area label attribute again. Okay, type area label message body, and we can use another attribute here. We can use row attribute. Okay, type a row text box like this and check wait for selector. And then we can use the value, maybe thank you for downloading Automa extension. Like this, with the value of typing delay 30. And the last action is click on the send button. Like this, we can use the aria label again. Back again to the editor and type aria label. Like this. And then we need to add close tab here with loop breakpoint blocks. Like this. For the ID emails. Okay. And then let's try to save and execute this workflow. It will open Google email and type the first user email, the subject, and message body. And it's already sent one by one like this. Now it's done. Next, let's try to scrap tweets from a Twitter account to your Google Sheets. Watch me out. Okay, for sure, we need to create a new workflow with a name, maybe get tweets. Open this workflow and add a new tab block here. Open your Twitter account or any accounts that you want to scrap the tweets. Copy the URL and paste it to the new tab URL here. Connect it with the trigger block, and then we need to add a delay block here to make sure the tweet has already rendered here. Maybe we can add a delay 3 seconds or 3000 milliseconds here, like this. And for sure, we need to add a loop data block. Back again to Twitter, and we can use the element selector. Click on the list button and click on the tweet elements here, like this, and copy the CSS selector back again to the editor. And we can update the ID to tweets and loop through elements and paste it to the CSS selector. Connect it with the previous block. Now we can add a tweet column and time on the workflows table here, like this. So we can use a get text block here to get the time data. Back again to Twitter and click on the that element here. Copy the CSS selector and back again to editor. Paste it to the element selector and replace this with loop data at tweets. And then we can enable the error handler here. Select continue flow, like this. And we can duplicate this block to get the tweet data here. Okay, back again to Twitter and select the tweet text here. We have an element that has an attribute data test ID here. Copy the value and back again to the editor. We can replace time to data test ID tweet text, like this. Connect it with the previous block and don't forget to add a loop breakpoint block with the ID tweets. And then for sure, we need to add a Google Sheets block here. So you need to create a Google Sheets file like this and share it to service@automa2.im.gserviceaccount.com. Click on the share and click on the share anyway here, like this. Back again to editor, and we need to get the spreadsheet ID on the URL here. Select this, copy and paste it to here with the range A to B column. And for sure, we need to update the drop down here to append spreadsheet cell values. Okay, we can get data from table and we can add a close tab here. Like this, we can save and execute this workflow. It will open Twitter and it will update on the Google Sheets like this. It's a wrap. If you have any questions, join our Discord server and please tell me what you want to know more about Automa by commenting below. And thank you for watching.